This is the all-new 2021 Renault Kiger. It's the Renault version of Nissan Magnite. Obviously, both are based on same platform. The front of the car looks very aggressive, with LED DRLs mounted with indicators on the top, and with three octa LED headlamps, which resembles Bugatti Chiron. Front bumper is well designed, and lot of chrome treatment has been made to make it appeal premium. Side profile is good, looks very SUV-ish. The tires are 16-inch with diamond-cut alloy wheels. The variant badge is mounted on the side of the car. The front door do not get chrome treatment as well as no request sensors. Door feels little heavy and opens quite wider. The rear door has no request sensor, but also opens as the front one. Roof rails are functional and well finished, with the rear spoiler and the shark fin antenna is painted with piano black. So overall the design looks very adventurous. The high mount tail light is small in size, and the rear looks aggressive with the C-shaped tail lamps, and there are no fake exhaust. The entry inside the car is easy, and seat have comfortable positions. The steering is very nice to hold and grippy. The dashboard gets dual tone treatment, one color along with the AC vent. The button on the steering wheel have smooth functioning, and the center console is very practical. Storage below armrest has cooling function and is very spacious. You get a wireless charging option and a storage below that with a 12 volt charging socket and a USB port. The push start stop button is smooth and surrounded by a crystal chrome design. AC knobs and control links are normal, but switches for hazard light and locking looks premium and special. AC ventilation is decent and cools the cabin in the all direction. The 8-inch infotainment system supports Android Auto, Apple CarPlay with Park Assist. Door gives proper grip to hold. Window control buttons are smooth and feels rubberish. And you get one touch roll down for driver side window and with child lock system. Unlocking handle is smooth and can be operated with a single finger. The steering is tilt adjustable, which makes the driver convenient. The driver seat gets three-way manual adjustments, which fills the shortage of telescopic steering adjustment. The clutch is on the lighter side and short-footed, so does the accelerator pedal. There is no proper dead pedal on offer. Now let's get in the rear seat of the new Kiger and see how it feels back in there. Door opens quite wider. You get proper grip to enter inside. Seating positions are comfortable. The legroom, knee room are quite decent. The floor is almost flat, and you get center armrest with two cup holders. Rear passenger gets two separate ventilation along with a 12 volt charging socket. Now let's check out the boot of the car. The lift feels somewhat heavy, but it's not so difficult to operate. And you get 400 liters of boot space with second row seats up. And you get 890 liters of boot space with second row down. The seats are 60-40 splittable, which helps to increase the boot space. Below that you have a spare wheel which is of 16 inch. The multi information display is clear and loaded with graphics. You get analog style tachometer and digital speedometer. You get 3 driving modes for turbo variant, economy, normal and sport. Economy for efficiency, sport for the performance and normal for normal cruising. In city, the ride quality feels very steady and smooth. The steering is on the lighter side so that you can cruise around the city very easily. Turbo lag can be overcome in short rev range, and the performance is adequate with short gearing ratios. The suspension manages to overcome the bad roads very well, and you feel a little body roll in this car. Overall, the ride is smooth, enjoyable, and the braking performance is fabulous. The car is best value for money, and the performance is impressive, so does the braking. So what do you think about this car? Let us know in the comment section.